What if you could buy a fraction of a skyscraper in New York, or a piece of a famous painting, or trade stocks and other assets 24/7 without a broker? That's the idea behind tokenized assets and why some of the biggest names in finance are paying attention. I'm Bola, back here in the Binance studios, and today we're talking about tokenized assets, what they are, how they work, and why they could change what it really means to own something. The concept is actually quite simple. A tokenized asset is a digital representation of something that already exists. That could be a stock, a bond, or even real estate. What matters is what it represents: ownership. But instead of your right to ownership being buried in a bank's database or stored on paper, it's recorded on a blockchain as a digital certificate. And that's where the advantages come in. Once it's on-chain, that certificate theoretically becomes far more flexible. You could split it into fractions so more people can invest. You can transfer it in minutes instead of waiting days for settlement. And you can even program it with smart contracts so things like dividends, interest, or rental income are paid out automatically. If you spend any time in crypto, you may have already used a form of tokenized assets without even realizing it. Stablecoins like USDT or USDC are digital tokens that represent a real US dollar, backed by reserves like cash or government bonds. They're essentially tokenized dollars, and they've become one of the most widely used applications of blockchain today. In theory, almost any asset could be tokenized, but right now, most of the excitement is around financial products like treasuries, funds, and stocks. Take tokenized stocks. Normally, if you want to buy shares in a company, you go through a broker. After settlement, you hold the stock directly. But you can only trade during market hours, and access can be limited depending on where you live. A tokenized stock works differently. It's a blockchain-based token that mirrors the value of the real stock, usually backed one-to-one by actual shares held by a custodian. So, when you buy a tokenized stock, you're not buying the stock itself. The real share stays with the custodian. What you hold is the digital token that represents the rights linked to ownership of that share. That structure makes it far more flexible. And you can trade it 24/7 from different parts of the world and even buy just a fraction of a share. And this isn't just theory. BlackRock launched a tokenized US Treasury fund in 2024, and by 2025, its tokenized shares had grown to nearly $3 billion. Qualified traders can even use them as collateral on some crypto platforms. That's just one example of how tokenization has moved from being an idea to becoming real financial infrastructure. It's changing the way people own, trade, and access assets. And the space is growing fast. McKinsey projects the total market could reach $4 to $5 trillion by 2030. While it's so early, the potential is clear. Tokenized assets aren't about creating brand new things to own. They're about taking the assets we already know and giving them a digital upgrade, making them faster to move, easier to access, and ready for a 24/7 world.